Joined now by the chair of the Senate Foreign Relations Committee, Senator Bob Corker. Senator Corker, thank you for joining us this morning. We just heard Martha say a lot of people were shocked to learn that we have almost 1,000 troops right now in Niger. As chair of the Foreign Relations Committee, do you understand what America is doing there? And do Americans know what we need to know about that mission?
Well, George, we received a congressional notification earlier this year that we had 600 troops there. I know those grow over time. And I visited the area. There's a tremendous amount of extremism there that we're countering. As far as the specific mission, those details we don't know, but we do know in that general area there are a lot of people that wish us harm. So throughout the Sahel, we have a large number of forces.
So we should be there?
Look, yes. Now let me say this, George. A week from yesterday, I'll be beginning a debate about the authorization for the use of military force. What's happened through the years is these efforts have spread throughout the world without a lot of congressional input. And I know that Senator McCain and others, myself, obviously want to make sure that Congress is playing the appropriate role.
Let's move on to tax reform. President Trump is heading up to Capitol Hill today to talk to you and other Senate Republicans about that. Yesterday, he seemed to take any reform of 401ks off the table. Are you confident he's got the will and the skill and the commitment to get this done?
George, I haven't seen that yet. There's about $4 trillion in loophole closings, credits, all kinds of things that you're very familiar with in tax code that have to be closed in order to do what has been laid out. And so there's, you know, it's easy to talk about cutting people's rates and doing this, that the things that benefit people, but the spinach, if you will, is in doing all of these reforms, which make filling out your taxes much more simple, and which is what the American people have asked for years. But if you start taking things off the table before you get started, you make that very difficult. And so what I hope is going to happen is the president will leave this effort, if you will, to the tax writing committees, let them do their work and not begin taking things off the table that ought to be debated in these committees at the proper time.
You've said you're not going to vote for a tax bill that increases the deficit. According to the current plan the White House has talked about, it's hard to know because it's not all down on paper,
right,
but probably increase the deficit, most experts say, by about $2 trillion. But when I asked the Treasury Secretary about that, Steve Mnuchin, here's what he said.
We believe there'll be $2 trillion of additional growth. So under our plan, we believe this will cut the deficit by $1 trillion, and that's what we're focused on. And that's with a conservative 2.9% GDP over the 10-year period of time.
Do you buy that explanation that growth is going to pay for this?
Well, we'll see, George. As you know, not all tax reform is equal, and so we'll have to see. Obviously, we need to look at scoring mechanisms. We'll go through the process. I don't want it. We have the greatest threat to our nation is not what's happening in Northern Africa or what's happening in North Korea or any other place. It's really us, George, our inability to deal with our fiscal issues with $20 trillion in debt, another $10 trillion on current projections over the next decade.
You've had some tough words for President Trump. You compared the White House to an adult daycare center. You said he's putting us perhaps on the path towards World War III and said most of your colleagues agree with you behind closed doors. Any second thoughts about those comments?
No, George, I don't make comments that I haven't thought about. The first comment was obviously in response to a very fallacious tweet that the president sent out. The second comment, really, when you look at the fact that we've got this issue in North Korea and the president continues to kneecap his diplomatic representative, the Secretary of State, and really move him away from successful diplomatic negotiations with China, which is key to this, you're taking us on a path to combat. And so, you know, I want to support these efforts that are underway. The president undermines our Secretary of State, raises tensions in the area by virtue of the tweets that he sends out. And I would just like for him to leave it to the professionals for a while and see if we can do something that's constructive for our country, the region, and the world.
Sounds like no second thought. Senator, thanks for your time this morning.
Thank you.